The intenders of the highest good are honored to bring you The Code, 10 Intentions for a Better World. We arrived in Ashland, Oregon, intending that we find the perfect place for our intenders' roadshow. Right away, the Circle of Terran manifested for us. It was the ideal location for a very special group of intenders to come together. From the moment we got there, we knew we were on sacred ground. It was unforgettable. Join us now as we take you with us on the road with the Code.
So those of you who are interested in learning how to do this process, we refer you to the Little Intenders Handbook and also to the website at www.intenders.com and to our first video, which will show you how to do an actual intender circle. It's called the Intention Process video, and you can get all of this off of the website. We started with fridges and things, and we ended up with the more sublime. Start with the mundane, and move your way up. And there are no rules, so you might as well do them all. Since there's no limit on what you can think, there's no limit on what you can intend, literally. I was in Albuquerque. I lived in Corrales, New Mexico for a while and had a fellow come to my doorstep one night, and his name was Ralph, and he had been writing a book about the laws of manifestation and interviewing people, and he'd ran across the Little Intenders Handbook and looked me up. And Ralph interviewed quite a few people about these, and he'd made what he called a progression of power, a series of six steps or stages we go through as we step into our empowerment. And so I'd like to share those with you now. And the first step or stage is testing. You just make an intention, you test it, and you'll see you'll get a win right away. Especially if you line that intention up with the highest good, because our guides told us all along that there are invisible helpers. We are coming in contact with the invisible realms more and more nowadays, that there are other dimensions and other worlds all around us, and that these invisible helpers, they rally to the sides of those who openly say that they stand for the highest good. And they see to it that your first few intentions are manifested unmistakably, so you can't miss it. So we say go for it. Test it, you'll see, you'll get a win. Test it again, you'll get another win. You'll see that the law of attraction, the laws of manifestation do in fact work. And that'll take you to the second step that Ralph called trusting. Trust, because after you've seen it work a few times, you begin to build up trust in this process. And what are you exactly trusting in? You're trusting that your thoughts do create your world. And your intentions will manifest as you direct them. And again, for me, it has to do with trusting that there are helpers, that there is guidance available from other realms who will rally to our side if we but call them forth. And my guidance has told me to emblazon three little letters upon my consciousness. A-S-K. Just ask and we'll be helped. So, and that builds trust, which takes us to the third step that Ralph called confidence. You begin to get confident with it. Now you use it in times when maybe you wouldn't have used it previously. You get confident with this process, using it more and more, which takes you to the fourth step, which he called a knowing. And after a while, you just know. You know. Your intentions are going to manifest for you. You just know it. You become a knower. That's a big leap, actually. But there are several in this room right here who are right at that place. And that takes you to the fifth step, which Ralph called courage. Now you use this process, this intention process, courageously. Maybe previously you'd be intimidated, thinking, well, what are people going to say if they find out I'm getting empowered? Use it anyway. Just do it. You know, no holes barred, just using this process. Which takes you to the sixth step, which Ralph called fortitude. You become like a rock, like the impenetrable castle atop the mountain. Lord over all your survey, master of all your survey, able to manifest at will. And everyone here and everyone watching this video is in one of those six steps, those six stages, working their way toward the top of the mountain. As we all step into our power, indeed, we have abdicated our place upon the throne of our own power by buying into the limitations and the illusions and the identifications and so forth that we've been taught since we were little children. But now that these times are upon us, these times of great change, these times that we came here to take part in, why we are in fact rising to the occasion, stepping into our power, and bringing not only ourselves, but our fellow travelers, our brothers and sisters up with us. So be it.
So it is.